So the problem statement here is that typing on small devices is very inconvenient and slow. And we want to know, is there a simple solution to this problem where the potential solution makes the experience of typing on small devices as convenient as typing on a regular keyboard? And also, would this proposed solution apply to a regular keyboard also? Now, currently, when typing, the only variable is the key. So the idea is to introduce another variable in addition to the key being typed. And that second variable would be which finger hits the key. So assuming the user types on small devices using only one hand, meaning each key can have five different fingers that can hit it, and assuming we only have eight large keys on the small screen, this means that we have 40 letters that can be conveniently typed with those eight keys. So to get the idea to work, the small device or phone need to have a way to detect what finger hits the screen. And the better hardware solution is to have an on-screen fast fingerprint detector that can detect the finger that hit the screen anywhere on that screen. And another potential hardware solution is to have one or more conveniently placed cameras that can identify the finger that hit the screen. So to demo this idea, we'll do a potential simplistic implementation where we will assume that the phone camera gives us a canvas of on-off pixels representing the finger that hit the screen, and where we will assume that we recognize the finger the picture represents using a hope-filled network. So we start by training the network on five fingers of the user right or left hand, and we will assume the on-screen keyboard would be two rows of four buttons, meaning eight buttons total. So the input would be the pixel picture of the finger plus the button that was hit, and we will use the hopeful network to recognize that finger from the pixel picture. So the finger number and the button number would give us the character that is being typed. We'll start with a quick demo. So this is button number one, this is button number two, etc., button number eight. And if finger number two hits button number one, we end up with this character. If finger number three hits button number five, we end up with this character, etc. And this is the pixel picture for finger number one pattern, and this is the pixel pattern for finger number four. And let's start by doing some training, and we're assuming we have a pixel drawing board of five rows. So we divide each one of those by 5, we end up with 9 columns. So this pixel picture represents finger number 1, and this one represents finger number 2, etc., finger number 3, number 4, and this one represents finger number 5. So let's suppose we want finger number 4 to type on button number 1. And maybe let's distort it here. So we end up with character D. So we did pick up finger number 4, even though we had this distortion in the input pattern. And maybe have finger number 4 also hit button number 8. Also distorted, and we end up with the character type 8. I will start by importing. This downloaded zip file. And we will create a new project. And copy this code. Let's create a new package. And move this one. So let's go here. Those two, and refactor this code. And let's go ahead and remove this code and this. And the number of neurons will be 45. So we have 45 pixels representing each finger, and we have 5 rows on the drawing board. So 45 divided by 5 gives us 9 columns. So each one of those is an on-off pixel. And this is first finger, this is the second one, etc. This is finger number 5. And we have 8 buttons. So this is the first button, this is the second one, etc. This is button number 8. And if the first finger hits the first button, we get the letter A. If finger number 5 hits the first button, we get the letter E, and if the first finger hits button number 8, we get the number 5, and if finger number 5 hits button number 8, we get the letter 9. And this method does training. So it picks up the input pattern for each one of the fingers and call train on that pattern, the neural network train method. And this method, we give it the image of the finger that typed and the button that was typed on. And it returns what character is being typed. And this method prompts the user for an image pattern for the finger that is used to type and the button that is clicked. And here we call run on the neural network to identify what finger is doing the typing. And let's add this method. Here. And it's the same as this one, except we don't have a line separator. So one string representing the picture of the finger. And let's add this display method. This code here. So let's go ahead and run it. So this is button number 1, this is button number 2, etc. This is button number 7, and if finger number 1 hits button number 1, we end up with letter A. If finger number 3 hits button number 4, we end up with the letter R. And this is a pixel pattern for finger number 1, this is for finger number 2, etc. And this one for finger number 5. So let's start by doing some training. So this is finger number 1, and finger number 2, etc. And finger number 5 representation. So let's go ahead and maybe type this character. So we need finger number 3 and hitting button number 1. Let's distort it. And this is button number 1. So even though we have this distortion here in the input, It did recognize it as finger number 3. So the character type is this character. Let's try another character. Maybe type this character. So finger number 5 will hit button number 4. Distorted. So even though we have this distortion here, it did recognize it as finger number 5. And this was the character typed.